want to be a speaker, man. I went to guys, man, I want to be a speaker. The guy looked at me and said, man, if you want to be a speaker so bad, all you got to do is speak. I was like, whoa, I'm going to be a speaker. Woo! There was only one challenge. I couldn't speak English. Friends, and that was not a small little challenge. I want you to imagine you want to be the next Michael Jordan, but you got no arms. You want to be an Olympic runner, but you got no legs. I wanted to be a world-class speaker, and I couldn't what?
Speak
English. I remember turning to this guy in my own sign language, like, sir, you don't understand, I can't speak English. The guy didn't even blink. He took a book from the table, put it inside his suitcase, looked straight into my eyes, and he said, where there is a will, there is a way. I was like, look, sir, you don't understand. When I speak, people laugh on my face, you know? Again, he took another book, put it inside his suitcase, looked straight into my eyes, and he said, where there is a will, there is a way. And I'm thinking to myself, maybe that's one of those things that you read between the lines, because I'm not getting what he's getting at, you know? Anyway, he takes his suitcase. Now he starts walking towards the door, so he's leaving the building. And I'm just standing there. Friends, now think about this. The only thing I ever got excited in my life, and the guy was walking away, so I started saying a whole bunch of stuff to the guy. Now, between you and I don't think he could understand me, because back then, I couldn't understand myself. But anyway, he kept on walking and walking and walking, and all of a sudden, he stopped. He put a suitcase on the table. It makes a 180-degree turn. And now he started walking towards me. Now, something you got to understand. This guy is about the size of Shaquille O'Neal. Scary kind of looking guy. No matter who you are, if you see this guy in the dark alley, forget about a dark alley. Daylight, you cross the street, okay? This guy is walking towards me. Guess what I'm doing? I'm walking back. I don't know, should I feel my pants and start running away from this guy? And then I'm kind of keep walking back. He keeps walking towards me. I'm walking back. And he keeps walking towards me. I'm kind of between the wall and the guy. And he's kind of looking down at me. I'm kind of looking up at him. And he looked straight into my eyes one last time. And I will never forget this. As he looked straight into my eyes, and as I looked back into his, he said, well, there is a will. There is a way. Then he went on to say, he said, the minute you desire your dreams, as bad as a homeless person desires shelter. He said, the minute you desire your dreams, as bad as a starving person desires food. He said, the minute you desire your dreams, as bad as a drowning person desires air. He said, at that moment, you make your dreams into reality. At that moment, you make the intangible into tangible. At that moment, you will find the way. I looked at him, he looked at me, he walked away, never saw him again in my life. Friends, I didn't quite understand what he meant that night, but something happened. See, as I left that building, as I went back to my dorm, as I laid my head on the pillow, the last thought that came to my head that night was, I'm going to be a speaker. When I woke up the next morning, I was sitting on the ledge of my bed. The first thought that came to my head that morning was, I'm going to be a speaker. As I walked through campus that entire week, that entire month, that entire year, the thought that kept coming back again and again was, I'm going to be a speaker. Friends, it's been a few years later. And today, as I go all across the country, as I reach people from all around the world, as I step on stage in front of thousands of people, excited, waiting to hear the first word that's going to come out of my mouth before I say one word. I look at the audience looks back, and at that point, the first thing that comes to my head is, I am a speaker. Friends, why am I sharing this with you today? You see, you might not want to be a speaker. That was my dream. You might not have the same obstacles and challenges that I had, like being on the street, begging for food, or being constantly laughing in your face. Friends, those were my obstacles and challenges. The reason why I share this with you is because I know by fact that you do have a dream, true or false?
Yes.
And I also know that you do have some obstacles to overcome, true or false?
Yes.
Friends, the minute you develop that intense desire for what you want, there's really no obstacle you're going to overcome. There's no challenge you're going to surpass. There's no distance you cannot endure. You will become unstoppable. See, a friend of mine asked me, how do I know that my thinking is in the right path towards success? And when you're frustrated and you don't think about your frustration, when you yell that, curse out, discriminate against, or even put down, and you don't think about how to get even. When you get knocked down, when your whole world begins to collapse on your shoulders, when you keep getting bad news and you don't think about why life is so unfair, when you're burying debts, when you have no money and you don't think about the scarcity of funds, when your car breaks down, when you break down, when everything everything you have begins to fall apart and you don't think about fixing. When there is death or destruction, you don't dwell on what's missing or destroyed. When you're sad, depressed, intimidated, scared, or hopeless, and you don't think about being sad, depressed, intimidated, scared, or hopeless. Because all you think about is what?
It's your goal.
It's making your dreams become a reality. So people say, man, why would I think about making my dreams become a reality when I'm feeling hopeless? Why would I think about making my dreams become a reality when I can't even get off bed in the morning? Friends, because a dream gives you something to live up to look forward to be excited about. Some people say to me, man, I have a dream, I'm not that excited. Friends, if you have a dream and you're not that excited, maybe it is not your dream. If you have a dream and you're not that excited, maybe it's your mom's dream, your uncle's dream, your dad's dream, your instructor's dream, your dog's dream, it's surely not your dream. If you have a dream and you're not that excited, maybe it is time. Time to find a new dream.